Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Nick Delgado. I have a very important video reply to Is Olive Oil Healthy by Dr. Josh Axe, and then I'm going to follow it up with some more commentary.
Hey guys, Dr. Axe here, founder of DrAxe.com and Doctor of Natural Medicine. Today I want to answer the question, is olive oil healthy, and talk about the many health benefits of olive oil. And I might surprise you in this video to let you know, olive oil can be an incredible superfood. The problem is 98% of olive oil today is not true extra virgin olive oil. And because of it, much of our olive oil today is fake and can actually have some negative health benefits. So in this video as well, I'm gonna teach you and show you at the end how to pick out some real quality olive oil. You know, my wife and I, Dr. Chelsea, a few years ago went to Tuscany, and we were in an area there called Cinque Terre, and I had some of their pesto and their olive oil, and I remember holding up the olive oil and smelling it, and it smelled and tasted like fresh herbs were exploding in my mouth. It had such a strong and potent scent, and I said to my wife, I said, wow, this is the best olive oil I've ever had. I said, it's unlike anything I've had in the U.S., and one of the things, I started doing a lot of research during the trip and once I got back from the trip and found out that the majority of olive oil today is laced with other oils like soybean oil, canola oil. So it's actually not good for you. It's actually toxic to the body. And I really started learning over there as we did some cheese tasting, olive oil tasting, and wine tasting tours, really seeing the process that they go through and caring for and really creating amazing quality olive oil. And so first thing when buying olive oil, you want to make sure that it is first pressed and cold pressed. I'll talk about more of that about the end. But if you're buying quality olive oil, some of the things you're going to find in there, number one, it is packed with polyphenols. And polyphenols are a type of antioxidant that really helps support both the brain as well as the heart. And so if you're looking to lower cholesterol, if you're looking to lower blood pressure.
Okay, so Dr. Axe brought up that olive oil, 98% of them are tainted with corn oil or canola oil, and it makes it rather toxic. Furthermore, he mentioned that he went to Italy and tasted the most amazing olive oil because of its virgin characteristic, and he mentioned it should be cold pressed processed. He also then ignored the fact that that's not the problem with olive oil. Olive oil itself is highly processed. It's only been since the 1905 that the cold press process was made available. And it's just much like if you take a whole food like beet and you pull the sugars out of beets or the sugar out of sugar cane. We know beets are good for you, but when you pull and process a food and pull all the sugar out, it's not good for you. The same with olive oil. Olives are good for you, coconut's good for you, but when you pull the oil out of coconut, you pull the oil out of olives, it's not good for you. Now, I will agree that the polyphenols will stabilize or have a good antioxidant effect, and that tends to stabilize blood sugar to an extent. However, oil itself tends to worsen insulin sensitivity, and I'm going to document that for you here shortly. But let's go further with what Dr. Axe has to say.
Looking to support your brain and focus and even prevent long-term diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson, we know that olive oil is a great superfood because of those polyphenol, those fat-soluble antioxidants. Also, we know olive oil is full of what are known as monounsaturated fatty acids as well as oleic acids. And these type of fatty acids are very good.
Okay, so he's saying that the polyphenols is rich as an antioxidant, that it's good for heart, healthy heart, preventing Alzheimer's, dementia. Yet, what he doesn't really understand is that oil itself is very thick and greasy and sticky. So when it pours into the bloodstream, anything more than like a teaspoon, a tablespoon has 14 grams of fat. For example, you could make hundreds of olives to make a tablespoon of olive oil. It takes 14 ears of corn to make a tablespoon of corn oil. So the point is, it's just too processed, it's too concentrated. It's so sticky and greasy, that's the nature of oil. Mechanically, it's sticky. So whether it's monounsaturated, oleic, whether it's polyunsaturated or saturated fat, that's really not the problem. Although certainly there's an association with saturated fat and animal products because animal products tend to be also very high in cholesterol, lacking fiber, a whole host of issues. But let's go a little bit further.
very good for the heart. They also support support balancing hormones and help lubricate your joints. And
so again, Dr. Axe is saying that the olive oil helped to lubricate your joints. Okay, listen, synovial fluid, which is in the joints, is actually a carbohydrate. Oil that you consume cannot get into the joints of your body. If it did, it would be disaster. It would thicken your blood. It would cause the blood cells to stick together. It restrict oxygen to the cells. In fact, that is one of the known causes of arthritis. Overly thick blood, sludging the blood. It's called rouleau. It's hyperlipidemia. It's related to very high triglycerides. And we know that oils themselves turn into triglycerides. They're pure fat. So to even say that oil could lubricate the joints, it's completely mythical. It can't happen. So let's go further.
And last and not least, olive oil is also packed with vitamin E. You know, vitamin E is crucial for heart health. Vitamin E is crucial for having healthy, glowing skin. So again, vitamin E, another very important fat-soluble antioxidant that is found in great amounts in extra virgin olive oil. So again, if you want to improve the health of your brain, your heart, as well as your joints and your hormones, olive oil is a must-have in your diet, and it's a key element of the Mediterranean diet. And we've seen through medical studies that those who are following a Mediterranean diet, which is high in olive oil.
So he's emphasizing extra virgin olive oil. It's such a great marketing technique that the food industry has put upon the general public. It doesn't matter that it's highly processed. In fact, it's overly processed is the point. And to say that it actually can help combat various cardiovascular diseases. The fact that it's high in vitamin E, that's good. There's nothing wrong with that. You can get vitamin E from a rich variety of whole natural foods rich in essential fatty acids. The point is to get your whole foods from whole nuts, seeds, avocados, olives, coconut. Go that direction. Do not take the separated oils. In fact, when you do your salad dressings, get a fat-free salad dressing, Warden Farms, or have a vinegar concentrated. There's some good recipes and availability out there. So herbal mixtures without the added oils, so it doesn't thicken your blood and make that healthy salad into a damaging, overly grossly high in fat, which actually is one of the leading causes of high blood pressure. Too much fat in the blood is a common cause, a well-known cause of high blood pressure. So let's go further.
And wild-caught fish, so a lot of healthy fats, have lower incidences of cardiovascular disease. So again, olive oil, amazing superfood for that. Now, here's the flip end of this. Most olive oil today is not true olive oil. It is loaded with...
Okay, so he made a blanket statement that the Mediterranean diet has a lower overall rate of cardiovascular disease because it has healthy fats, for example, olive oil, or in the case of wild-caught salmon. The fact is that the Mediterranean diet is richer in vegetables and fruit and fresh food. They don't eat as big a portions of greasy, fatty foods. And there was a study that teased out those who were drinking, say, wine, which has an antioxidant, and teased out studies showing those people not using, say, olive oil, and those using a whole foods diet, getting their whole fats, and they had a much lower rate of cardiovascular disease. The Mediterranean people do not have the lowest overall rate of cardiovascular disease. In Okinawa, in certain places of Asia, now we're finding the Latin cultures that eat a lot of beans. So the higher the fiber, the lower the fat intake, the lower the risk of cardiovascular disease. Totally, we know this to be true in the science.
It's either watered down with soybean oil. In fact, there's a great great article and study out there talking about is your olive oil fake? In fact, you can do an online search to find my article on it and just look up Dr. Axe olive oil fake. Okay, if you do that Google search, you'll find my long form article with every detail about even my 5-step program on how to pick the best olive oil and the olive oil I personally recommend. So again, just Dr. Axe olive oil fake on Google and you'll find it on there. But again, here's what you wanna do to find good and real olive. Well, let me say this. The fake olive oil out there, because it has soybean oil and genetically modified canola oil, it's gonna cause heart disease, it's gonna be highly inflammatory, whereas the Mediterranean diet in olive oil is anti-inflammatory and help can reverse disease. this other fake olive oil is gonna be causing major health problems. So here's what you wanna look at, and here's how you know if you're getting good quality olive oil. Number one, now you can't always doing this when buying it, but once you get it at home, smell it.
Okay, so he's saying that soybean oil and the canola oil that's laced in the American's olive oil is the main cause of inflammation and cardiovascular disease, that olive oil itself is safer and healthier for you. Yet study after study is not showing that to be the case, that any oil, whether it be olive oil, canola oil, soybean oil, monounsaturate, polyunsaturate, that's just where the molecule is on the carbon molecule, the saturation point, that doesn't play a role. Although some will say the saturated fats will increase cholesterol, we know that coconut, and those who eat a lot of coconut in the South Pacific, they have slightly higher cholesterol compared to islanders that don't use the saturated fats of coconut. And yet both groups have overall low rate of cardiovascular disease because when they eat coconut, it's not coconut oil, they eat whole coconuts. And although their cholesterol is slightly higher from the saturated fat of coconut, it doesn't cause a problem with cardiovascular disease because instead of a cholesterol of 160, it's say 170 or 180. Whereas the average American starts at a cholesterol of 200 and higher, and most Americans are eating way too much animal product and then dousing it with oil, which makes it worse. So just keep in mind, if you have high blood pressure, for example, the oil will thicken the top number. The 120 will go to 140 and higher because the blood gets too thick. The bottom number, 120 over 80, the 80, that goes up from animal product, only from animal product. Cholesterol, the butter ghee, the use of cheese and fats and lobster and tuna and all these foods, chicken that are high in cholesterol. You gotta go to a plant-based to be clear of cardiovascular disease. Let's go on.
I mean, I'm smelling with this olive oil, I'm smelling pepper, I'm smelling fresh herbs, I'm smelling olives. I mean, I have a really, it is a very distinct, strong aroma and smell. That should be with your olive oil. Your olive oil should always come in a dark glass bottle, whether it's dark brown or green. Again, there should be a dark bottle there. The other thing is, if you put your olive oil in the refrigerator, it should turn a little white and cloudy there as well. So it should harden up a little bit or at least get cloudy there if you have the right olive oil. So again, putting it in the fridge, you know right away, opening it, you smelling it. Another thing, you want the dark bottle, that's number three. Number four, you wanna look for extra virgin olive oil.
Now, okay, so really it's a moot point. If you're buying what he claims to be quality olive oil, it has to have a dark container, the jar. It has to have a certain scent, a strong aroma. That's all fine and good. And again, for those people who use a touch of oil, and I mean like a teaspoon for whatever reason you might use it, that's fine. But don't be using it as part of, I've seen people use in recipes like a quarter of a cup, an eighth of a cup, really pouring the oils in. That's just massive amounts of triglycerides. Now you have it, Dr. Nick here. I'm gonna transition to another playback related specifically to the dangers of olive oil. Stay tuned. Hi, Dr. Nick Delgado here. Olive oil is not healthy. Michael Klaper, MD. I'm going to do a reply and a comment.
Eat food as grown, as Dr. Hans Diehl says, which brings us around to restaurant food. It's delicious, and as a bachelor, I used to live in restaurants, and my blood pressure was up, and I was carrying 10 pounds too much. The reality is that restaurant food is ethnic flavored salt, sugar, and fat. When my friends ask me to go out for dinner, I say, let's see, do I want Italian flavored salt, sugar, and fat? Ooh, maybe Chinese salt, sugar, and fat. Ooh, haven't had East Indian salt, sugar, and fat in a while. Ooh, Thai flavored salt, sugar, and fat's really nice. Restaurant food is full of salt and sugar and fat. That's what make it taste so good. That's what the chefs are putting in the ingredients back in the kitchen there. And then they serve it to you with seared flesh or overcooked vegetables. It's the reality. Does that mean you should never ever step foot in a restaurant? You're going to have to. There's social pressures, et cetera, to do that. All I can tell you is that don't kid yourself that anything healthy is happening in those kitchens. They're not. And you don't want to eat a whole lot of it. I've gotten my restaurant eating down to very seldom as possible. Less is more when it comes to restaurant meals. And you know what I do before I go out to eat? I eat. and I have a salad and or a bowl of soup at home, so I'm not famished when I walk into the restaurant. I don't polish off the half the basket of bread before the waiter gets there. So eat before you go, and order as healthily as possible. Order the vegetable soup, the steamed greens, eat it, and get the heck out of there as soon as you can.
Dr. Klaper is absolutely right. Restaurants, depending on the nature of the restaurant, you've heard of greasy spoon. They use a lot of fats in almost every recipe. The Indian restaurants are notorious. The vegetables are just floating around in oil. Chinese restaurants tend to use a lot of oil. I found that Vietnamese pho restaurants, their soups, if you get a vegetable pho soup, has no oil whatsoever. You can't even find a drop of oil. The Vietnamese tend to have along with the region of Cambodia and Vietnam, they have amongst the lowest rate of breast cancer in the world, probably and very likely due to their low fat intake, high vegetable rich diet. They use their staple, as you know, might be rice. In Okinawa, the staple is more sweet potatoes and oranges and so forth. So it's interesting that Dr. Klaper is absolutely right. Humans tend to add salt, sugar, and fat. A little bit of salt in the foods may be okay, but the amount of sugar that restaurants use, I think Dr. Klaper gave a great recommendation. Eat before you go to the restaurant so you're not famished. Certainly we like to go out to restaurants for social reasons. I eat out a lot myself, but for example, when I go to restaurants, I get side dishes. I order them in a special way. I tell them to do, say, baked potato instead of fried potatoes. I tell them at Mexican restaurants to bring beans cooked in water, not refried. Bring us a plate of salad and lettuce and tomato without the olive oil. Bring me corn tortillas and some guacamole. So I'll assemble that together in to make soft tacos, which makes it very, very tasty and nutritious without getting an overabundance of excess processed oils and sugars and some salt. Let's go on.
Okay. So let's get to it. In back of everybody's mind, what about olive oil? Oh no, not olive oil. It's heart healthy. There's a lot of literature back and forth about olive oil. And I'm not going to wait around in this study and that study, but I'm going to tell you some facts that are absolutely indisputable about olive oil. Both animal fats and vegetable oils are fats, and they all have 9 calories in every gram. A tablespoon of olive oil has 13.5 grams of fat, and every tablespoon has 120 calories in every tablespoon. As a result, you're a big olive oil fan. Liquid oils will help do that. And very importantly, it'll keep you there. If you are overweight or your friend's overweight and they're trying to lose weight and they are eating olive oil, they are kidding themselves. It's going to keep you stuck. It is liquid fat. That I can tell you.
Dr. Klaper is absolutely right. There is no such thing as healthy virgin olive oil. It's approaching 14, he says 13.5 grams of fat per tablespoon. And they even did a study years ago where they gave people 800 calories. They put on a tracer on the fat to see when it was consumed, that clearly 800 calories in a day, a person should have burned all the calories. But what they were shocked to find with the tracer, that the fat itself did not get digested, even on a sub-calorie diet of only 800 calories. Obviously, the average person needs 2,200 calories to 3,000 calories, depending on their size and weight. But what they found in activity level, but what they found was fat isn't easily digested. It isn't easily burned for calories that I meant to say. So the oil itself will go travel through the bloodstream, gum up all the blood cells, which causes rouleau and clumping in the blood, poor circulation, reducing blood flow to the brain by as much as 30%, which is not good as a risk for future risk of cancer, because low oxygen levels in the body can increase the risk of cancer. All that oil gums up the bloodstream. Then it goes through, after it bypasses through the lacteals and lymphatics and messes up the immune system, it goes directly to the fat stored cells instead of being burned for calories. So while you're on a low-calorie diet, adding all these keto foods and olive oil and things, go to whole olives that have the fiber intact. So at least they're slow to absorb. I think you look up a couple olives as a couple grams of fat. There's not that much. So eat the whole olives. That's going to be safe. But the olive oil or the corn oil, the safflower oil, whatever oil, avoid it. Don't use it. Use alternatives. Cook in pans like titanium pans that don't require oil. And that's one way to go. So let's go further.
So yes, olive oil has some adverse health effects, and mostly it contributes to obesity. And studies have been done. They've looked at overweight women in Greece. The Greeks, by the way, are the fattest country in Europe. They have the highest rate of obesity of all the European nations. And when they looked at the women who were obese, and they did fat biopsies and analyzed the actual fat in their fat stores, 55% of the fat came from olive oil. It sticks to you.
So that's pretty interesting. The Greeks who use a lot of olive oil are amongst the heaviest people in Europe. Also, they found that fat biopsies showed this concentrated olive oil in their fat tissues, which lends to the point when we put tracers on fat when it's consumed, that the body will just not digest it. It'll just go right to, if you're genetically tendency to a lot of fat cells, right to your fat stored cells and cause you to be plumper and plumper and plumper for every day you use oil. Let's go further.
So the reality is olive oil is really dense with calories. It is the most calorie dense food we have, 4,000 calories in every pound. We're trying to get a 4-to-1 ratio of omega-6 to omega-3. Olive oil's ratio is 14-to-1 omega-6 versus omega-3. And we're trying to lower saturated fat. They want no more than 7% saturated fat in our diet. Olive oil is 14% saturated fat.
Okay, so he's making the point that olive oil and other oils are the highest caloric dense of any food on the planet. 4,000 calories per pound, but if you just break it down per quarter cup or whatever use, these oils lend an extreme amount of calories. Now, I know Rich Rollo, who's a plant-based health individual who does a lot of marathon running, he'll say that because he runs these ultra long distance marathons that he'll burn the calories eventually due to a conditioning effect, much like the book Fit or Fat. The body will become more efficient if they're doing long distance consistent exercise on a daily basis. After several months, a person could theoretically burn more fat than they do glucose. But that's not the argument here. The concern is that so many people are obese and they're consuming unnecessary added calories. And those olive oil has essentially most of its vitamins and minerals ripped out. It has a little vitamin E, it has some antioxidants. But the point is you want to go on a no added processed oils. But you want fats, essential fatty acids from nuts, seeds, avocados, and olives. That's the way to get it. He goes on to say that the saturated fat in olive oil is 14%. It should be under 7% is our goal. I'm a little less concerned about saturated fat based on the South Pacific studies in coconut and the consumption of those whole coconut. It's really more about processed and unprocessed food. So let's go a little bit further.
How does pouring 14% saturated fat help you get to your intake of 7%? It's irrational. The take I'm trying to get there is that pouring olive oil on foods does not suddenly make them heart healthy. This salad is not being made heart healthier because this poor person is pouring olive oil on it. These greens are perfectly heart healthy on their own, even more so. The meal this person is about to eat would not be classified as heart healthy. If she pours some olive oil on her salad before eating the sandwich, it is still not a heart healthy meal. It is still not a Mediterranean dinner she's having here, even though she poured olive oil on her salad. This is what Mediterranean diet has become. Oh, I've used olive oil on my salad. Unhealthy eating is unhealthy eating. This is how your blood looks after you eat rice and beans. You eat a meal filled with fats and oils, and this lovely clear blood turns into a substance that looks like this. Not everybody shows that this grossly, but this is fat in the bloodstream. This is lipemia. And every time you eat a fatty meal, a wave of fat goes through your bloodstream.
That's a very important picture Dr. Klaper showed. And by the way, that picture of the slide of the collection blood tube after eating rice and beans or vegetables or fruit, the blood looks very clear when it's spun in a centrifuge. The top part, the blood serum, is absolutely clear. It's kind of got a little yellow hue to it, and the red cells are at the bottom. When you spin the blood of almost any American who's eating typically high oil, fat, meat, cheese, eggs diet, the fat accumulates to the top and it looks milky, dark, kind of creamy fat, white color, yellowish fat color. And that's very, very dangerous. That's why we have amongst the highest rate of cardiovascular disease, diabetes, arthritis, cancer in the world. Now, on fasting, you're going to show a lower level of fat in the blood tube than after eating. So I even tell people, check your blood in the middle day. It's called postprandial. And there's other studies now substantiating that fasting blood levels isn't real accurate, because years ago they told people they had to fast for their blood test because they were getting such high readings of glucose and fat levels and triglycerides. They said, well, it must have been what you ate today. Well, it's what you eat every day. So you've got to get to the point where, and by the way, those test tubes, Dr. Klaper probably pulled a slide from years ago when he and I worked together in the 1979, 80, 81. He worked with me with Nathan Pritikin, and then later at the shortly after Pritikin with the Delgado Protocol, Delgado Medical, that is, in Torrance, California. So I've known Dr. Klaper for a better part of approaching 40 years. So it's really refreshing to see his message is still clear. It's still the same. Let's get rid of the processed foods and eat more of the whole natural foods. Let's go on.
It goes through your bloodstream. As I said, not everybody shows it this densely, but everyone has a wave of fat going through their bloodstream when they eat fatty foods. Remember, your body is never not looking. You can't tell your body, look over here, and have a cheeseburger down there. Who's that?
That's great. Dr. Klaper, your body is never not looking, you know, and, you know, don't look here, I'm going to eat a cheeseburger, or don't look, I'm going to eat a steak or something. You know, the beauty is I've had live blood microscopy in my office, and for 40 years, I've checked my blood in various conditions. I've checked literally tens of thousands of people's blood, and Dr. Klaper's absolutely right. Blood doesn't lie. It's never not looking. In other words, when you make these concessions, maybe once in a while you cheat a little bit, but I know the level of cheating, and cheating's got out of control for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And that's the problem why we can associate so much cardiovascular disease and degenerative diseases, because of the overconsumption of greasy, processed, sugar-laden, cholesterol-ridden foods. So let's go a little bit further.
Your arteries know. Your liver knows, your heart knows. If you are going to be eating a gooey, greasy pizza like that, it's going to turn your blood fatty. Even if you pour olive oil on your salad before you eat this greasy piece of pizza, it's still going to turn your blood fatty. Your body is not fooled. It's never not looking. Don't kid yourself.
Yeah, so eating greasy pizzas, putting olive oil on your salad, thinking that's going to make it heart healthy, so it's closer to a Mediterranean diet, that's foolish. If you do eat pizza, there is a cheese called diet cheese, but its fat content's a little bit high. So you need to limit that amount. I've noticed that, you know, a few slices of diet cheese on a gluten-free crust with some fat-free tomato sauce. We have some recipes in our cookbook, Simply Healthy Cookbook, over 240 recipes that we've collected from around the world. And my original book, Grow Young and Slim, will give you some great tips. And my newer writings, Acne Be Gone for Good, but definitely take a look at the Simply Healthy Cookbook. It'll give you just incredible, great recipes made with no added oils, but taste great with the herbs, the spices, and the intuition of international cuisines.
Let's Looking, go. Don't kid yourself about olive oil making things heart healthy. Spaghetti Alfredo with a little bit of bacon and egg yolks there to make it really challenging. This is dripping with oil. If you then pour some olive oil on your salad before you eat the Alfredo, do not think this is now a heart-healthy meal. It's become a cover for the rationalization of atrociously dangerous eating. And this has been documented. Dr. Vogel has given people food with olive oil in it and to study the effects of their arteries. And he looked at the Mediterranean diet on endothelial function.
Yeah, so the postprandial, meaning after consuming food, the effects of Mediterranean diet on endothelial function, meaning the blood vessels. After using olive oil, Dr. Vogel has reported in medical literature that you can look up yourself, is highly toxic, very damaging, and destroys, depletes nitric oxide, which nitric oxide is a vasodilator. It helps preserve the endothelial lining, the circulation to out throughout your entire body. We use a product called Beet Vitality to increase the nitric oxide levels. And we also encourage, so you don't nullify or lose the benefits of plant-based nitrates from the organic beets and the greens, that you don't add oils into the food and then nullify or lose all the benefit of the nitric oxide. So Dr. Klaper is right on. Let's go further.
And he blew a blood pressure cuff. He gave them some olive oil, blew a blood pressure cuff for a few minutes, deflated it, and instead of the usual increase in blood flow, there was no increase in blood flow. Olive oil paralyzes the blood vessels from the normal dilation. It's not friendly to artery stuff. And as they said in the study, in terms of their postprandial...
Yeah, so he points out that the olive oil paralyzes any benefits of the vegetables and the whole food because the olive oil actually forces blood pressure up based on before after use of the consumption of oil that elevates blood pressure. Why? Because the oil just pours right in the bloodstream. It coats each individual red blood cell. And when you watch my video here called How to Become Diabetic in 6 Hours, you'll see under a high-powered microscope to the blood vessels in the eye that the blood vessels, when the red cells get coated with fat, the capillaries get blocked because each red blood cell is supposed to squeeze through the capillary beds one by one, but when they clump together, they can't squeeze through. All the fluid goes to the surrounding tissues and the blood pressure goes up. The circulation of the brain and all the tissues reduces drastically. So Dr. Klaper is completely right. And in this conclusion of the postprandial effects, meaning after consumption, the components of the Mediterranean diet, let's hear what he says in conclusion.
In terms of their postprandial, that means after eating effect on endothelial function, the beneficial components of the Mediterranean diet and the Leon Heart study diets appear to be the antioxidant-rich foods, including the vegetables, fruits, and their derivatives. Most likely the heart benefits of Mediterranean diet are due to it being basically a vegetarian diet. They're probably getting healthier in spite of the olive oil, not because of it. So don't see olive oil as
So he's saying the Mediterranean diet is healthy because it has a greater array of fruits and vegetables and whole food than the typical Western diet. And in spite of the use of oils, which has a damaging effect, their net result is better than if they didn't. But imagine the cultures or you yourself preparing your Mediterranean fresh whole foods as used by our Simply Healthy cookbook without the oils that damage or cause you to lose the benefits of whole natural foods. Try over 250 incredible recipes in our cookbook that we've tried and tested and spent 15 years gathering recipes from around the world where they don't even use oil in their cooking. And then those countries or recipes that did use oil, I modified them, we tried them, we prepared them at classes. People got to try them at food demonstration events and preparing foods with no added oils, and it makes a huge difference to your health. Within days, within weeks, it takes about 10 days, I published my study about my experience with Tony Robbins, and in one of the chapters where we tested over 793 people, or 696 people, that is, and in that published study, I reported in the book that in 10 days, when we tested these individuals a baseline for their lipids, for cholesterol, triglycerides, glucose, that within 10 days of oil-free eating, where they used my cookbook, the earlier version of that, How to Look Great and Feel Sexy, but the newest book is Simply Healthy Cookbook. But by using that at the Tony Robbins event at Master University in the buffet-style foods, in just 10 days, all 1,000 participants in two different classes that I work with had remarkable results when we retested their blood 10 days later. Their cholesterol, triglycerides dropped an average of 30-40%. Their blood sugar improved, and all because they were eating healthy, oil-free recipes. And along with exercise. Exercise by itself won't accomplish these results. We've done independent studies to tease that out. Let's go further.
Health food. Pouring oil on your food is pouring oil on your food. You don't really want to do, there's no reason to do it medically or nutritionally, and it leads you places you don't want to go. So, no, he's taking away olive oil too. What do we do without olive oil? Well, what do you really use olive oil for? Two things. You stir fry your veggies in it, and you make salad dressing with it. That's about all you really use it for. Well, you can certainly stir fry your vegetables in seasoned vegetable broth. It works just as well with a nonstick pan. No reason that you have to use olive oil. In fact, you don't want to use olive oil. It breaks down in a skillet. Never heat olive oil if you are going to be using it. Well, what about salad dressings? Well, you can certainly make salad dressing without oil. We do it at our clinic three times a day. You just take a blender, put some fresh vegetables in it, maybe half an apple, maybe half a piece of an orange slice, and hit the button, and turns into salad dressing. Want a little fat in there, throw in a piece of avocado.
That's a great
or a couple
idea.
Of walnuts.
Just make your salad dressing with a blender, veggies, apples, citrus, some herbs, spices, and it's wonderful. Just put a little water in there and mix it, and then it pours out, or some vinegar, balsamic vinegar is great, and it'll work perfectly. So here you have it. You have alternatives, and you have a way. Within literally 10 days or more, just within that short period of time, your blood cholesterol, particularly your triglycerides, will reduce, your circulation will improve, and this is great advice for anyone who wants to reach their ideal body weight, to improve their circulation, and to have a heart-healthy day. Thank you, Dr. Nick, saying stay tuned for the next segment. I think it'll shock you when you study what I have to say. This is Dr. Nick Delgado here saying, I want to share with you how to become diabetic in 6 hours. Why would I do such a thing? It's because most of you don't understand that we must reverse engineer to understand the origins of toxic foods that are too high in fat, particularly oil, including olive oil. You'll see a segment in this portion where I'm actually consuming pizza, which is loaded with fat in the cheese. If it's a sausage pizza or whatever, there's a segment where I'm eating a sandwich that has cheese and ham or something. So all that within 6 hours, I was able to take my healthy blood sugar level, where leading up to this, you have to know I was eating fruit, vegetables, beans, rice, no added oils. My blood was pristine. Even after eating, my triglycerides and cholesterol and glucose were perfect, immaculate levels. And you'll see how we demonstrate this under a high-powered microscope, along with a special, what's called cholestatic machine, that immediately checks the blood levels every hour on the hour for 6 hours until my levels built up so high in fat, it's fat that desensitizes the insulin, and you're gonna see the full truth. Watch this.
Hi, I'm Dr. Nick Delgado. I'm going to teach you how you can become diabetic in 6 hours. Why would I do such a thing? I will explain how fat, even from supposedly healthy fats like extra virgin olive oil, can desensitize insulin, causing insulin resistance, releasing sugar into the bloodstream. We're going to prove this using a cholestatic machine, which measures triglycerides and also glucose levels. We're also using a high-powered phase contrast microscope hooked up to a plasma TV. This sets the stage by looking at the properties of fat, how sticky any kind of oily fat is, in clumping the blood cells together, thickening the blood, eventually leading to diabetes, high blood pressure, cancer, or arthritis.
Now here you see the actual red blood cells, and you can see as they float by, they just slide off each other. So that's very good. See, there's virtually no clumping. We'll have the reading in a couple minutes, and the experiment begins. You can see that my baseline on the TV screen showed healthy blood. Then I drank a half a cup of oil. We did baseline tests to measure cholesterol triglycerides. My triglyceride is less than 45. That's when I first drew my blood, less than 45. See the less than number? The HDL shows 37, but my total cholesterol is fairly low. Non-HDL, LDL, it didn't even read because my LDL is so low, okay, overall. And my glucose was 96. So after 2 hours of consuming the olive oil, my triglycerides doubled. They went from less than 45.
Granted, if I had taken someone who already follows a typical American diet, doesn't exercise much, I would have got a quicker rise, but you know, it's gonna take just a little bit more effort to mess up Nick's blood.
So my triglycerides doubled, and that was enough to convince me the olive oil, although they were still in a reasonable range, if I continued to wait, the olive oil would have continued to elevate my blood levels. But then, to make it worse, I added pizza and a sandwich with cheese and meat.
People eat dinner at about 8 or 9 o'clock at night. 12, 1 or 2, when fat rolls in the blood and reaches its peak 3, 4, or 5 hours after it's been ingested.
Now notice after 2 hours of adding the pizza and the cheese, and look on the clock, it says we started at 6 p.m. There it is at 10 p.m. because we let 2 hours pass after the consumption of olive oil, 2 more hours after the consumption of the pizza and the cheese meat sandwich. And some would blame the bread in the sandwich. I saw that in one of the correspondence there in the replies of YouTube in the earlier video. But I've done it where I've eaten rice and bread and even added sugar literally to my diet and fruit, and that's all I ate with no added oils or meats, and the blood sugar and triglycerides stayed low on the total 6 hours and on into the next morning. So let's just see what happened. And by the way, the reason I'm laying on the floor, I'm not playing, I passed out. There was so much oil that I'm not used to from the olive oil, from the pizza, and from the sandwich, that all that oil clumped up my blood cells, and I'm gonna show you that on the TV screen in a moment, but I literally had to lay myself down because my brain, I had brain fog, and it put me into a state of semi-unconsciousness, literally. I mean, that's what happens when people, after they eat a heavy meal, they get sleepy and tired. What do? Instead of going to sleep, they don't have time to, so they reach for coffee to cut through the grease to wake themselves up with a drug stimulant, caffeine. But I don't have to drink coffee because I keep my blood clear all the time, except for the case of this experiment. Let's go on.
Look at that. Look at the thickness of the fat. You know, to go from completely clean, where you couldn't even find a particle, to massive amounts of particles of fat. So keep in mind that triglycerides and free fatty acids and total lipids desensitize insulin, and glucose will continue to go up. Within a couple more hours, I'll be diabetic.
So after a total of 6 hours, I was able to push my triglyceride to 214, and it's continued to increase. My cholesterol increased to 196, and that's mainly because the VLDL, the blood sugar 131, that's diabetic. Now people say, well, you don't test after eating, but you can, and that's the best time to test.
For another couple hours, it'll reach a peak, and then it'll gradually start coming down.
Now, if you saw in the background, the TV, it was showing droplets of fat on the big TV screen from a microscope, magnified 6,000 times. But you could also see the blood cells sticking to each other because of all the grease. Prior to that, you couldn't find the little spots of triglycerides and the blood cells even trying to stick together. They separated perfectly. So notice in summary, after 2 hours of consuming olive oil, extra virgin olive oil, my triglycerides, which were under 45, climbed up to over 78 within only 2 hours. But then after adding the pizza and the cheese sandwich, the levels climbed and climbed, and you can see by the, I even measured them the next morning, and it took a full 8 hours that night, 12 hours it remained elevated till the fat started to clear from my otherwise normally healthy blood. Let's take a look.
Consuming even healthy fats like olive oil still elevates total lipids and desensitizes insulin, causing blood sugar to rise, proven by the Kalstek laboratory device. Fat is mechanically sticky and it coats the cells, causing them to clump together as seen on the high-powered microscope. Capillaries are smaller than individual red blood cells. When your red blood cells stick together, the capillaries become blocked, reducing the body's total circulation by over 20% for up to 12 hours.
That's absolutely critical. I hope you all got that. We literally, under a high-powered microscope, could see all the blood cells that were healthy separated, but after consuming the extra virgin olive oil, consuming the added fat from the cheese pizza and the meat, all that fat rolled in my bloodstream, and you can see each hour we are measuring the cholesterol levels, but more importantly, you can actually see the capillary beds at the highest level that the normally the red cells squeeze through one by one, but they're all clumped together, reducing the blood circulation by as much as 20 or 30%. So the combination of a disastrously high keto fat diet is toxic unless when you're fasting for your blood test. But check your blood when you're eating. If it's small portions, it may not push the levels up that high. But if you're on a high fat keto diet, this is what's going to happen. It's going to worsen your blood levels. You may lose weight if you restrict an entire category of foods like sugar and carbohydrates because you may be taking in less calories, but your fat cells will actually gain in fat concentration based on tracer studies.
Years of repetitive fatty meals causes a lack of oxygen at the cellular level, increasing the risk of certain forms of cancer, arthritis, and hypertension. Despite what the American Heart Association cookbook will tell you, when you consume oils which are high concentrations of fat exceeding 15% of total calories, you're eating your way into the grave. It is healthy to consume whole olives, nuts, seeds, avocados, and coconuts in small amounts as nature intended, as proven by the longest lived cultures. When you eat, do it to sustain your life rather than end your life.
As you can see, when we consume foods, eat the unprocessed whole avocado, olive, nuts, seeds, coconut, fruits, vegetables. Don't add the oils. Learn to prepare your foods without added oils. Use the Simply Healthy Cookbook method. Watch my playlist on healthy cooking, and we'll give you all the tips of how to make this very tasty. Now, for about the first 5 or 6 weeks, I noticed when we had people going on the program over the last 40 years that I've been training people, that their taste buds aren't used to not having oil that soaks up all the sugar and the added salt and so forth, that taste you're maybe used to extremes. But after about 6 weeks, your palate improves, your taste buds improve, and you're tasting the wonderful herbs and spices and whole food, and your brain is clear, your body is clear, and you're en route for a lifetime of great health. If you love this video, share it. I know it's controversial. It flies right in the face of what other doctors are claiming is heart healthy, and it's not. The top doctors at Rush in Chicago there's over 14 doctors that are plant-based, oil-free, recommending to the cardiovascular patients to prevent reverse cardiovascular disease. Dr. Caldwell Esselstein, I have interviews with Dr. Esselstein and other world-famous doctors who wrote the book Prevent Reverse Heart Disease. There's study after study that will confirm to you that this is the way to prevent or reverse, according to Dr. Michael Greger, over 20 different chronic diseases in his book, How Not to Die. And in my book, you can learn Simply Healthy Cooking, along with the ebook Grow Young and Slim, and my newest book release, Acne Be Gone for Good. Now you have it. If you enjoy this, give us a like, share it, be strong, be well.